The Philadelphia Association of Black Journalists honors author, columnist, and radio talk show host Solomon Jones with its 2014 Online Journalist of the Year Award.
When I started writing in earnest, it was when I was living at the Ridge Avenue shelter. And I used to come out in the lunchroom in the evenings and I would write poetry, I would write stories, and I wrote this particular story called Black in the System. And it was about what it was like to be in a homeless shelter.
This moment for me is just an overwhelming moment because I know this city from the streets to City Hall.
I'm the morning host on 900 AM WURD, the Wake Up With Words show, the family man columnist for the Philadelphia Daily News.
For parents in Guatemala and El Salvador, the decision to send a child on a dangerous journey where kidnapping and other horrors await them is a difficult one.
A video commentator for Aldea News, the Philadelphia Experiment blogger for Newsworks, a published author. I have 8 novels. I think the thing that people like about my writing is that it's honest and that it's real. There are different audiences for everything that I do. So for my daily news column, for instance, I'm writing for an audience that is, you know, it could be old, it could be young, it could be black, it could be white, and it is. For WHYY, what I do is a little bit different because I'm blogging from a black perspective for what I know is a white and affluent audience.
And so it is overwhelming for me to be here now as your morning host for WURD AM Radio, the voice of the black community.
Here at WURD Radio, my audience, my message is specifically for the black community.
This is Solomon Jones on 900 AM WURD, the Wake Up With Words show. We are talking about the Queen Lane implosion and what happens after the buildings come down.
But I think it's a huge responsibility because I know, based on the way that we do it, based on the paradigm that I want this thing to operate from, I know that there are other people listening.
And the question is, you know, will that be something that is going to be beneficial to the people of Germantown?
The story that really stands out for me, I wrote for an outlet that no longer exists. I was writing for an outlet called Access Philly. I wrote a series called Abandoned.
When we moved in, with no empty houses.
And it was about a neighborhood in North Philadelphia called Sharswood. The community is devastated. You know, it looks like a bomb hit it. The violence that comes along with the abandonment, the crime that hides in those cracks and crevices with that abandonment. And then I talked to some of the longtime neighbors who stayed there, and they told me a story of courage.
A bullet just flying and children getting shot. Innocent people, you know. When you leave the house, you don't even know where you're coming back or not. So you just pray and hope you can make it back safe.
We can discuss, we can bust, we can argue, we can debate, but at the end of the day, you'll leave this show with more information than you came here with. Not only that, you'll leave this show armed with the only thing that really matters, the truth.
Man, I love this community. I love my people. My people keep me going, man, because black people crack me up. I mean, I love my people because we have this shared experience. We have this shared stress. And we get through that stress with laughter, and we get through it with stories, and we get through it with love. And to the extent that I can serve our community and help other people to have access to some of the things that I've been fortunate enough to have access to, from information to education to jobs. You know, sometimes it's just about hooking people up with the right moment.
On the other side, we have Councilwoman Cindy Bass.
With the Philadelphia experiment, when the numbers came out about black children being disciplined more harshly and more often than other children, I wrote about that from the perspective of a black father and about, you know, what it feels like to know that your children are going to be more susceptible to punishment just because of the color of their skin. We just have to be honest and just tell our story and don't worry about the niche. Don't worry about, you know, appealing to a specific segment, but just be honest and just tell your honest story. And I think that appeals to people.
Solomon Jones, Philadelphia Association of Black Journalists, 2014 Online Journalist of the Year Award honoree.